Tick, tick, tick. At first, you didn't notice the ticking. Then, in a fleeting moment of silence, you heard it clearly. Tick, tick, tick. Like a macabre, mechanical heartbeat. Hearing the madman giggle, you realize that the ticking is coming from you. The traitor has planted a bomb on you! Right now, each hero takes a pentagonal item token, representing a time bomb. What you know about the bad guys. The traitor is a demolitionist who has rigged each of you with a time bomb. You don't know how much time you have left. The traitor also holds a trigger capable of detonating the bombs, but only when in your room or a room adjacent to yours. The adjacent room does not need to have a connecting door. The bombs you are wearing are also ticking, though, so they might blow up if enough time goes by. And if that's not bad enough, the traitor is working on the big bomb. You must stop the demolitionist before he or she kills you all. You win when the traitor is dead and at least one hero survives. How to stop the traitor? At least one of you needs to have your time bomb defused so you can kill the traitor before the big bomb explodes. Once per turn, you can attempt a knowledge roll of 7+ to deactivate the time bomb strapped to you. If you have the madman card, you need only a 5+ on this roll. He recognizes the mad genius in the design. If your bomb is deactivated, discard your time bomb token. If the result of the roll is 2 or less, you activate the bomb, and all explorers in the same room explode and are killed. All of their item and omen cards are discarded. Instead of attempting to deactivate your own bomb, you can attempt to defuse someone else's, if you are in the same room and you have the hero's permission. The knowledge roll of 7+, 5+ with the madman, still applies, as does the penalty for rolling a 2 or less. The traitor will continue to work on the big bomb until killed,